so I just put it on my way. I'm zombie but awake, but I'm begun it away.
Well, what is good, my crazies? Yes, y'all, welcome back to the lab. Lee here in the Stoop, man. Y'all saw that title too as well. We got 10 new Mandela effects to blow your mind, get you going for this week with that too as well, man. Y'all remember that some of these Mandela effects might not be new to you, but they will be new to somebody else. So please respect that. With that said, if you like this at any time, y'all remember to hit that thumbs up, punch that subscription in the face. We are almost at 500 as well. Leave your comments down below about these Mandela effects and other Mandela effects that you like too as well. And also, wish me a happy birthday down below too as well, because this man is getting older. I'm telling you right that it's not till Friday, but wish it down there too as well. Now, with that and say thank you, let's get these 10 Mandela effects going for you. Number 10, we are going to be talking about Ed McMahon and the publishing clearinghouse, I know, and American Family Publishers. Yes, this one's kind of inconclusive. If in the book, it's kind of so weird and odd, but I do remember Ed McMahon going door to door to publishing clearinghouse with the publishing clearinghouse, giving out checks. That's what made Publishing Clearinghouse so huge. And I do know y'all are going to come at me and say, oh, but it was wrongly. It was never Publishing Clearinghouse. It was American Family Publishers. And yes, you are correct too, there too as well. He was the face for American Publishers or Family Publishers, as you see there. This is conflicting though, because if you look this up, as I was doing my research, I saw that American Family Publishers wasn't really established until 1990s. It's weird, as you see it right there. But then if you dig deeper into this, you understand that American Family Publishers was actually established in 1977. I know it sounds weird and odd, stay with me. Well, there are commercials out there with Ed McMahon doing those commercials for American Family Publishers back in the 80s, and well, it's conflicting in those two little areas. If American Family Publishers wasn't made until the 1990s, 1996 to be precise, why would that make commercials back in the 80s? Let alone American Family Publishers actually got bankrupt in 1999 or 1998. It is just weird, but do you remember Ed McMahon sending out checks walking door to door? Because that's really the Mandela effect, because a lot of people never remember Ed walking to door to door handing checks. Or do you always remember Ed walking door to door? Number 9 on this list is going to be the great and legendary Western actor John Wayne himself, Howdy Pilgrims. And I'm talking about his famous saying, a man's gotta do what a man's gotta do. That is what he said, is what he's saying, but the Mandela effect is affected John Wayne in that famous line and that famous saying. Well, here.
Walk around him. I'll be hanged if I go out of my way for any cur dog.
Man ought to do what he thinks is best. Man ought to do what he thinks is best.
Man ought to do what he thinks best. What the hell did he say? That is so, a man ought to do what he thinks best. That is not his quote. And to prove it with you, here you go through Google, looking it up, and you see it, man. A man's got to do what a man's got to do. It is so odd, so weird. How could we get that main quote of John Wayne, the legend, wrong when in the whole time? So we've been saying it the completely wrong. We've been saying a man's got to do what a man's got to do our whole life wrong. And now you're telling me a man ought to do what he thinks best? Man, what do you think about that one? Number 8 on this list is going to be the great Smoky Mountains themselves. And yes, the Smoky Mountains are the wonderful place in America to visit. Great time to go hike, biking, sightseeing, whatever. Well, while you're sightseeing, why don't you look at the spelling of Smoky? Yes, how do you spell Smoky? S-M-O-K-E-Y. Well, apparently E was never in Smoky. Yes, that is correct. You never spelt Smoky right that way. If you've been spelling it that way, it has never been Smoky Mountains with an E. It has always and has always been Smoky with no E. S-M-O-K-Y. Why would we spell Smokey that way? What do you remember? Do you remember spelling Smokey with the E in it, the S-M-O-K-E-Y? Or do you remember it how it is now and how you spell Smokey, S-M-O-K-E? Number 7 on the list, we're going to stay with the Smokey theme, and we're going to be talking about Smokey the Bear. Yes, the great guy that helps us prevent wildfires, forest fires, either way you say it. Understand that that's been changed now and then, but that's been changed because of different things and times and times. But this Mandela effect has to do with Smokey the Bear. And if you've been saying Smokey the Bear and pronouncing his name like that, yes, that is correctly how I remember it too as well. Smokey the Bear. And a lot of other people do too. But apparently it's never been Smokey the Bear. It's always been Smokey Bear. That sounds odd, don't it? Smokey Bear. It just doesn't ring to me. It's like, why would I listen to a Smokey Bear? You know what I mean? But don't take my word for it.
Smokey the Bear is entering his golden years, turning 70 years old today. He's evolved over the years and is even sending out selfies these days and blogging. But as ABC's Brandy Hitt tells us, his message remains the same.
Surprise! Today, Smokey the Bear is turning 70.
Fires.
And people have listened. Research showing 96% of Americans recognize Smokey, right up there with Santa Claus and Mickey Mouse.
So if it's always been Smokey Bear, then why is there evidence in news people saying Smokey the Bear, as well as books, illustrations with Smokey the Bear on it? But what do you remember? Do you always remember it the way I remember it, Smokey the Bear? Or do you remember it the way it's been and always has been, Smokey Bear? Number 6 on this list is going to be that classic comic strip from the Sunday's papers. We all just ran to go to the street and get the good old colored paper out, and he knew it was the comics. And I'm talking about Family Circus. Yes, the great family that got along, went along, did a whole bunch of crazy things. Kids got in a lot of trouble. And that is an amazing thing about the story of Family Circus. Well, if you remember it being Family Circus, like I remember it being Family Circus, the name being called Family Circus, well, apparently it has never been called Family Circus. The actual name of this comic strip is actually called The Family Circus. Yes, you heard me right. It actually is called The Family Circus. This is kind of odd and weird to me, just because I just call it Family Circus. You know exactly what strip I'm talking about, just like Calvin and Hobbes. You know, it's just what it is. But I always remember this being Family Circus. And now if you look it up on the internet and everything else, it says The Family Circus. But what do you remember? Do you remember it like I remember it being Family Circus? Or do you remember like it's always been The Family Circus? At the halfway mark, number 5 on our list is going to be that legendary king of pop, Michael Jackson himself. Y'all know I'm a Michael fan. I love Michael to death. Saw him in Frankfurt, Germany in 92 for his Dangerous concert, but that's enough of that. But I am talking about Michael Jackson and Billie Jean. Yes, Michael Jackson, Billie Jean, and that verse in the line saying, "Mama always told me, be careful who you love." Yes, you heard me say that right. Mama always told me, be careful who you love. Well, what if I told you that mama didn't tell me anything? It was mother told me.
People always told me, be careful what you do.
Mother always told me, be careful who you love. Mother, why have I been singing it? All these Michael Jackson fans have been singing it. Mama always told me, be careful who you love. Mama always told me, not mother always told me. It's too proper. It's just too proper. It's just too proper for Michael. It's too proper for us. And maybe it's a slang or not. But what do you remember that verse being? Do you always remember it being, my mama always told me? Or do you remember it the way it's always been, my mother always told me? Number 4 on this list is going to be that crazy frog. Yes, he hit the airways 10-15 years ago, blew everybody's mind. He was a Nola Rolla thing, and you know what I'm talking about. You saw it, man. I'm talking about the crazy frog himself. Well, What if I told you that the crazy fox is now showing off his dick? Yes, I am not worried about that. Yes, the crazy frog now shows his dick, his wee-wee, his penis, his doodle, if you want to call it. It is weird. I never remember him having that doodle out like that, like you see. It is so odd. It is so weird. But with this too as well, as I was doing this research, I came up across the original video of Crazy Frog, the Alex Foley method. And well, as you see right here, he doesn't have his willy hanging out. It's not, the cucumber's not dangling at all. You know, where did it go? It just suddenly appeared now. We are all starting to notice that his ding-dang is hanging around. It is so crazy to me. I don't know what to think about it. It's weird because I think we would have always noticed the Twinkie hanging down from there. But what do you remember? Do you remember it like I remember it, him never having the Twinkie or ding-dong swinging low like it is by his knees? Or do you remember it the way it is now with that log just hanging there going what it doing? Number three on our list is going to be that clear classic movie from DreamWorks, and I'm talking about the Bee Movie. Yes, the awesome, the great in one, Talking Bees, the Bee Movie. Well, I just said that totally wrong. The Mandela Effect on this one is that the Bee Movie was never, ever, ever called the Bee Movie. Apparently, the has never been on that title. It has always been Bee Movie. Does that seem really odd? Why would you just call something B-movie? It's the B-movie. It's always has been the B-movie. It is so odd and weird, and I can understand where Smokey the Bear ran to, or the Family Circus has gone, but you know, but the B-movie is what I remember. It's a classic movie. He was drinking honey. He brushed his teeth with honey. He put his arms in honey. He's fighting for honey and love and all that stuff. But what do you remember? Do you remember it always being called the B-movie? Or do you remember it like it always has been and always, guess, probably will be? B-movie? It's so hard to say that. B-movie. Let me know. Number two on this list is going to be that crazy cheesy cat slime going around. And I'm talking about Chester the cat, Chester Cheeto the cat. Yes, and his famous line, "It ain't easy being cheesy." Well, what if I told you it never was easy being cheesy? It's not easy being cheesy. But don't take my word for it. Listen to Chester himself.
That goes crunch. It's not easy being cheesy.
Cheeto's cheese flavored snack. Cheese that goes.
It's not easy being cheesy.
It's not easy being cheesy. That's not right in my world. I always remember him saying, "It ain't easy being cheesy." And I am not the only one that remembers that too as well.
God, there is no drummer better than Neil Peart.
It ain't easy being cheesy.
Just like I remember it. It ain't easy being cheesy. How can a television show that does brand stuff, product placements, everything, get that wrong? Tell me that. Now, what do you remember? Do you remember it the way it is now? It's not easy being cheesy? Or do you remember it like I remember it and millions of us remember it? It ain't easy being cheesy. Now, number one on this list is going to be that classic storybook tale, that just nursery rhyme, bedtime story, whatever you want to call it. And I'm talking about the three little pigs and the big bad wolf. Yes, and this Mandela effect has to do with the big bad wolf and his saying. Now, you are all saying it to yourself, "I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house down." Well, listen to this.
Open the door and let me in.
Not for the hair on my chinny chin chin.
I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in. I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house in.
I'll huff, I'll puff, and I'll blow your house in. Yes, that is correct. That's what you see right there. I huff, I'll puff, I'll blow your house in. This is so weird. You saw that from the original cartoon that I remember when I was a kid in the 80s. That was the show I watched. That's the one I remember. And I always remember him saying, I'll huff, I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down. But what do you remember? Do you remember it the way I remember it and millions remember it? Probably say it a thousand times, I'll huff, I'll puff, and I'll blow your house down. Or do you remember like it is now and always has been? I'll huff, I'll puff, I'll blow your house in. There you go, 10 new Mandela effects for you to blow your mind. If you did enjoy this at any time, remember to hit that thumbs up button. These blew my mind as I was doing the research because some of these were new to me and I know a lot of them, but I wanted to kind of do it different. It blew my mind looking these things up and just the shock of my childhood just getting thrown away in my water. But remember, man, what do y'all remember about any of these Mandela effects and ones I might have never talked about? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to wish me a happy birthday. If it's your birthday out there too, y'all, happy birthday. And remember, man, y'all keep your mind open because those eyes will see everything in front of them.
Hang up this phone, and then I'm going to show these people what you don't want them to see. I'm going to show them a world without you. A world without rules and controls, without borders or boundaries. A world where anything is possible. Where we go from there is a choice I leave to you.